If we look a bit moist and baggy beneath the eyes, that's because we just got back from the sweatbox that is MWC 2017. But the mental anguish wasn't for naught, as we saw some truly awesome mobile tech. Here's our pick of the best phones from MWC 2017. LG G6. Although LG's latest flagship phone packs a rather massive 5.7-inch screen, it's surprisingly compact once you get your mitts on it. That QHD Plus panel stretches across the majority of the phone's front panel, and with an unusual 19:8 aspect ratio, meaning not too much bulk. In fact, the G6 is built for movies thanks to its crisp resolution, Dolby Vision HDR support, and that stretched aspect. Packed inside, you get a powerful Snapdragon 821 processor, and around the back, you get LG's dual lens camera tech, with a wide angle snapper for cool looking Vista shots. Check out our hands-on review and comparisons with the best flagships of 2016 here on our channel. Sony Xperia XZ Premium. Sony's Xperia XZ flagship is still a rather fresh face, but it's already been superseded by the new Xperia XZ Premium, launched at MWC 2017. This 5.5-inch smartphone boasts the world's first 4K HDR screen, while you also get Sony's fresh new 19-megapixel rear camera with that seriously impressive super slow-mo tech built in. And this is the first mobile to come back in Qualcomm's super-powered Snapdragon 835 chipset, which boasts up to 1 gigabits per second download speeds, essential if you're streaming a load of ultra-high-definition HDR movies. Huawei P10 Plus. Huawei pulled back the curtain on a pair of blowers at MWC 2017, including the sizable 5.5-inch P10 Plus. Boasting a Quad HD screen for pin-sharp visuals, the P10 Plus is more of a media machine than the dinkier P10 handset. You get the same Kirin 960 chipset of Huawei's own design, but the Plus model has a meaty 6GB of RAM stuffed inside for even smoother performance. Then there's the 3,750mAh battery, which should hopefully keep you going for well over a day between charges. We've already unboxed the smaller Huawei P10 and revealed our full camera review for Huawei's latest flagship, so go check those out for a fun time. Moto G5 Plus. The Moto G5 Plus represents a noticeable departure from its G4 Plus predecessor, although once again, Lenovo's wallet-friendly handset packs an affordable price tag. The G5 Plus is more compact than last year's G4 and boasts a metallic finish for a more luxurious touch, but weighs the same as before at 155 grams. You still get a full HD screen, now reduced to 5.2 inches for easier handling and even sharper visuals. But most enticing of all is the Moto G5's new 12-megapixel camera, which sports an f1.7 aperture for capturing stronger low-light shots and some tasty bokeh, along with its dual-focus technology. Nokia 6. Forget Windows Phone. Nokia has a new owner at the helm and one that values the power of Android, which is why the new Nokia 6 comes with Google's Android Nougat 7.1 crammed inside. Considering the low €229 price tag, you get some solid specs with the Nokia 6, making it a solid rival to the Moto G5 Plus as far as value for money goes. A 5.5-inch Full HD display, Snapdragon 430 processor, 3GB of RAM and a 16-megapixel rear camera should make for a solid user experience. A pricier Nokia 6 Arte Black model will also be available at launch with an extra gigabyte of RAM and double the 32GB of internal storage. That can be yours for an additional €70. BlackBerry Key 1. BlackBerry is back in 2017 with the Key 1, which marries old with the new to satisfy long-term fans and BB noobs alike. Beneath that crisp, colourful and rather square 4.5-inch screen, you get a physical QWERTY keyboard that also doubles as a touchpad. A fingerprint sensor is built into the spacebar and you get BlackBerry's awesome DTEC security software to boot, which offers advice on how to beef up your phone's defences. The processor might not be as premium as we'd like, as a Snapdragon 625 runs the show, but our hands-on with the Key 1 showed Android Nougat running as smooth as butter, even with BlackBerry's excellent additions. This is the most functional and feature-packed BlackBerry phone to date, and we're already big fans. Here's hoping that 12-megapixel camera, which boasts the same sexy Sony sensor as the brilliant Google Pixel Snapper, can round off a truly excellent package. Nokia 3310. The original 3310 has amassed near-mythical status over the 17 years since it originally launched, and now Nokia is bringing it back with a revised version for 2017. This more slender and colourful reboot features a 1200mAh removable battery, microSD card support, and a fresh new glossy finish. The microUSB port makes the new 3310 a much more usable device, and you can expect up to a month of standby battery life per charge, or up to 22 hours of possible talk time. Definitely doing the original phone proud. Nokia's S30 Plus OS doesn't just put Snake back at your fingertips. The phone's 2.5G network support means you can jump on the web using the preloaded Opera browser, and access to services like Facebook and Twitter is also possible, albeit in a less complete form than on other phones. And unlike the original 3310, you can actually snap colour photos by way of a 2-megapixel rear-facing camera with an LED flash. Picture quality is as terrible as you might expect, at least when viewed directly on the phone, but for nostalgia fans, there's reason enough to pick up this fun and funky festival phone. Alcatel A5 LED. Okay, so the Alcatel A5 LED has some pretty basic specs, while the camera is quite a simple effort too. But just look at it, it's a mother f***ing disco phone, yo! Hopefully you enjoyed our top picks of Mobile World Congress 2017, and if you have any questions about any of the phones we just featured, you can drop us a line down below in the comments. We have a host more content on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/recombu. You can read more on recombu.com/mobile. Don't forget to subscribe, and thanks for watching.